हेलो एवरीवन, आई माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर सीमा वीरवान केसवानी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एंड हेड डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ जूलॉजी, एमएसपी आर्ट साइंस एंड केपीटी कॉमर्स कॉलेज मानोरा। हियर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द डिफरेंट स्पीसीज ऑफ द हनी बीज। सो ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड देयर आर 20,000 स्पीसीज ऑफ द बीज इन द वर्ल्ड हैव बीन आइडेंटिफाइड टिल डेट। बीज आर द क्लोज रिलेटिव्स ऑफ द एंट्स, wasp and the hornet. There is one genus, that is Apis, under which all honeybees fall. It contains all known species of honeybees, forming at least 44 subspecies. Bees in this genus are all characterized by their abilities to produce and store honey and build comb from wax. It is these properties that mankind has learned to use by learning to harvest honey from wild colonies or managing colonies in the hives. So now we will only look at the main species used for modern beekeeping. So honeybees that belongs to the phylum Arthropoda, class Insecta, order Hemiptera and family Apidae. So there are five well recognized type of the bees found into the world. First one is the rock bee, second is Indian hive bee, third is Indian little bee, the fourth one is European bee, and last is damer or the stingless bee. So out of these five types of the bees, there are three common in India. They are Apis dorsata, Apis florea and Apis indica. So now we will see the first, that is the rock bee. Its zoological name is Apis dorsata. It is the largest Indian variety with an average size of about 20 mm. They are giant bees found all over the India in sub-mountain regions up to an altitude of 2700 meters. These bees are the largest among the bees described. They are migratory species, and during the June and the July they swarm to the hills, but in winter come back to the plains. They construct a single giant comb in open about 6 feet long and 3 feet deep. The comb is fully exposed and huge from inaccessible branches of trees, along the side of steep rocks in the forest, and even from the wall, rafters and other part of the buildings. They shift the place of the colony often. Although they produce the highest amount of the honey among many other Indian species, that is 36 kg honey per comb per year, they are very ferocious and tendency to make unprovoked, sometimes fatal, mass attack on person who approach its hive. It is very difficult to rear. It is typically found in densely forested areas. Still, the indigenous people routinely harvest the honey and wax from the colonies. The rock bee honey represent a major portion of the honey sold in our market collected by the hive hunters. The worker bees are pollinate near about 12,000 flowers daily. These workers are very small and active. So this is all about the rock bees or the Apis dorsata. It shows the huge hives of the rock bees on the tree branches and on the walls. The next is the Apis florea. It is commonly called as the little bee. Apis florea, which is a miniature of the rock bee, it is a plain species and rarely occur about 1000 feet of a sea level. There are two species of the Apis florea are found. One is Apis florea, and second one is the Apis adreniformis. This Apis florea is called as the red dwarf honeybee, and Apis adreniformis, which is called as the black dwarf honeybee. It is found in southern and the southeastern Asia. The size of the bee, which is smallest among all four Apis species described, they build single vertical comb in open of the size of the palm in the branches of the bushes, hedges, building, cave, empty cases, etc. The bee covers the part of the branches of which the nest hangs, and with the propolis, which acts to deter the ants and the other crawling invaders. They produce about 0.5 kilo of honeybee per year per hive, and the production does not compensate the labor undergone on it. Due to the docile nature, that is, the obedient and rare stinging nature, their nest can be easily removed. They are not domesticated species, as they frequently change their place. They are not, it is probably the closest living descendant of the earliest honeybees that has spread from the Asia into the Middle East. Next, we will see the Apis serrana indica. That is, it is commonly Indian bee, found both in forest as well as in the plains all over our country. It is also called as the Asiatic or the Eastern or the Himalayan honeybee. Apis serrana, which is found into the vast range from northern India across Southeast Asia to Malaysia, Indonesia, the Philippines and the Japan. Apis serrana, which is characterized by the smaller, narrower body than that of the western bees and has quite marked yellow bands between the abdominal segments. It is renowned for adapting to seasonal changes rapidly. It is smaller than the rock bee but larger than the little bee. This bee builds many parallel combs in the cavities and the hollows of the trees, caves and such other hidden sites. This form is capable of being domesticated and is commonly reared in South India. The annual yield of honey is very low, that is 2 to 5 kg per colony. They are among the best Indian variety to be hired in artificial conditions. Next, we will see about the European or the Italian bee, that is the Apis mellifera. This Apis mellifera are the only bees that were not native to this country but imported from European countries, and slowly they adapted and distributed themselves all over the Indian subcontinents. They are the bigger than all the other bee honeybees except the Apis dorsata. The average honeybee production per colony is 20 to 40 kgs. They are less prone to swarming and absconding. They build a parallel combs. Due to the wide geographical spread of the Apis mellifera, a number of subspecies have arisen. Some of these being honeybees commonly in use by beekeepers around the world today. At least 30 subspecies of the Apis mellifera have been described throughout its wide range. It is the main species which has truly been domesticated by the humans for at least 5,000 years. It is the best species for the commercial point of view. So next we will see about the damer or the stingless bee. So there are two species of the stingless or the damer bees which are available. That is the Melipona and the Trigona. This Trigona is also called as the Tetragonula iridipennis. Their size are much smaller than the true honeybees. They build the irregular comb of wax and resinous substances in the crevices and hollow tree rings. They are important not because of their yield of honey, but pollinating power of various food crops. They produce only 100 grams of honey per comb per year. They can be domesticated. They are incapable of stinging because of the presence of the vestigial sting, but they bite their enemies or the intruders. This slide shows the hive of the stingless bee. It is the external morphology of the honeybee, which shows the white hairs on the thorax, hairy eyes, antenna, proboscis, wings, reddish brown abdomen, and important is the pollen press, which is present on the hind leg. Its important role is to carry the pollens. So this slide shows the pollen is attached onto the legs of the honeybees because these are the best pollinators. So in the next lecture we will study about the life cycle of the honeybees. Thank you very much.